As you know, my focus is not on being Mr. Fancy and knowing the name of every logical fallacy or trying to convince you that deductive or inductive reasoning is, you know, what are the fine points between the two? I don't understand all that stuff. I'm not that bright. It's the general gist of logic and reason that I care about. So I'm not going to use the fancy terms. I'm going to talk to you today about the straw man fallacy. And the straw man is essentially building up an argument and then defeating that argument rather than actually addressing the argument that your conversation partner is trying to make. So an example of that would be if I said, I think that society could organize itself without a government, then a straw man argument might be, so you are saying that blah, blah, blah. And let's say that the answer was, you're saying that you think it's fine for people to kill each other and then nothing should happen to them. Well, that wasn't the argument I made. I simply said that I think society could organize itself without government. And there are ways of handling problems without a government system to do that. And so when this person would respond the way they did, they're creating this whole new argument. I didn't make that argument. I can't argue with that. I didn't make that argument. And that's a very unfair thing. And most people do it accidentally. As you, as a person who is actually watching a video on logic, you are 1 in 1,000 probably. So most people are so stupid that they don't realize they're doing it. Or maybe they're part of that 5% that are not stupid, but they're savvy and manipulative. And they're doing it on purpose. Most people have just heard this done so many times that they do it themselves naturally. So don't fall for that. And, my suggestion would be if somebody made that comment or that argument back at you, would be to say, oh, I never really thought of that point. Maybe we can talk about that some other time. But right now, I'd like to talk about how I believe that society could organize itself without a government. And that might take them aback a little bit, and you can bust them in their logical fallacy and then get back to what it is that you really want to talk about. And having said this, most people don't have the IQ combined with the knowledge of logic and reason. They don't have the basic understanding of how to have a serious intellectual conversation. And, you know, maybe 1 in 100 people are actually capable of doing this. So I don't know. Really think about if it's worth your time or not to deal with these people. And I know that sounds very condescending, and it is. But it's true, I think. Just as only 1% of people have a really good singing voice. Well, only 1% of people have developed their skill set or have the natural ability to reason and understand logic. So pick your conversation partners carefully so that you don't get too frustrated and more importantly, so you don't just waste your time. Most people simply are not worth it.